We will now come to my favorite test, the limit comparison test. So why is it my favorite test? It works for many series, so you do not need to compute an antiderivative or to compare a full series. Now you only look at the tail of the series and see whether they tend to zero equally fast, which means that you only need to compute one limit to establish convergence or divergence. So how does that limit comparison test work? That is what you will learn in this video. Suppose we have two series with positive terms, an and bn. And suppose I know that limit n to infinity an over bn equals some number c bigger than 0. Only thing you need to know that your c is not 0 and not infinity. They are all positive, an and bn, so it will be a positive number. And as long as it is not 0 and not infinity, then your limit comparison test works. What will tell you, then either your sum an and your sum over the bn, either they will both be convergent, so either your sum over the an is convergent and your bn as well, or they will be both divergent. So how will you use it? If you know your sum of the bn converges, and if you can apply your limit comparison test, then you know the same of your sum over the an. So why does it work like this? Well, let's take a look at what this statement means. This means that if you get very far in your sequence, if your n is very big, your an over bn will get close to the value c, whatever it is. So if you get far enough, you can find two values, say capital M, a small m and capital M, around your c. So here they are, the small m and the capital M. Well, in the start of the series, you may be very far away from this, the coefficient may be anything, but as soon as you get very far with your small n, then your coefficient an over bn, that will become something like this. They will all be close to your c inside your interval small m, capital M. That's something you know. And you see, this works because your c is positive. That's why it works. So what does that mean? Well, your sum n from 1 to infinity over an, well, first take the first capital N terms. Well, that part will always be finite, no matter what your an will be. So don't have to worry about that. And then the last terms. Now, suppose you know that your series over the bn is convergent. Then you know that your an, if you are far enough, say starting at your capital N, that all your an are smaller than capital M times m times bn, because we know that this quotient over here, an over bn, is smaller than capital N, so your an will be smaller than capital M times bn. Now you know that your series of the bn converges, that's what you assumed over here, then you know that the sum starting at capital M will also converge of the bn, and it means that the sum of m times the capital M times the sum of the bn also converges. So you have a series above the an which converges, which means that the series of the an itself is convergent due to the comparison test. So now we know that given that the sum of the bn converges, we know that the sum of the an converges. We can do a similar argument the other way around. Suppose we know that the sum of the an converges, then we have a similar statement over here. We can estimate the bn. The bn are smaller than an over small m. Since we know that the an converges, the sum of the an over m will converge. So we can use a comparison test, and we know that the sum of the bn also converges. If the sum of the an converges, then the sum of the bn converges. And if the sum of the bn converges, the sum of the an converges. And something similar holds for divergence. You can do a similar argument. If the sum of the an diverges, then the sum of the bn diverges. And if the sum of the bn diverges, then the sum of the an diverges. Let's look at an example, one which we encountered before. N from 2 to infinity an equals 1 over n to the power 4 minus 1. I mean, did this one already using the integral test, which was very fun, a lot of fun. Took us quite some time because the antiderivative required factorization, etc., etc., taking limits. We ended up with a convergence series. Now, let's use the limit comparison test instead. We choose bn equals 1 over n to the power 4. Now, we know that the sum of the bn converges is a b series with p equals 4, bigger than 1, so that one converges. Now, we only need to compute the limit n to infinity an over bn. So, here we have our an over bn. Simplify a bit. You get n to the power 4 divided by n to the power 4 minus 1. And you can divide by the highest power, for example, and you end up with 1. So your c equals 1, it's neither 0 nor infinity. That means you can apply the limit comparison test. Sum of the bn converges, so the sum of the an converges as well. And we're done. So you see this limit comparison test. If it works, it works really fast, much faster than the integral test. And tells you immediately whether a series converges or diverges.